Thank you for the privilege of being in your service. It's wonderful for my kids to be here. We drove in today from Phoenix, Arizona. We just did 5 concerts over there, and they were wonderful, but this one's going to top them all. Is that true? Orchestra, you ready? Choir, you ready? Are your parents here? Are you kidding me? They're really here? From where?
From Spain.
From Spain. We need to greet them. That makes me even more nervous. Is it true that your father's a conductor?
Yes, he is.
Oh, ¿cómo está? I know nothing more than that. It's called It Is Well With My Soul.
Thank you.
I've been doing music for quite a few years, and it's been my observation that some of the contemporary music is being dumbed down from my point of view. So I decided in late winter that I would like to go back a few years and pick up some of the songs that we did at that other school I used to be at, and maybe have these folks experience some of them. This next one is one of those old songs. It's a Sandy Patty song, Almighty God. Song we've been doing for a couple of years, and I actually didn't like it very much. It's more peppy than I am, and but audiences tend to like it. Until Tuesday of this week, we got a letter at the university, and it was printed on paper, which is rare to get anymore. And it went something like this: Dear Dr. Bonner, I'm in the sixth grade, and on Saturday morning, you're going to be at our church at Camelback Seventh-day Adventist Church in Phoenix, Arizona. My favorite song is Praise You. And that stunned me, because I thought, praise you, rowdy song. And then she went on to say that she loved it and she had all the words memorized. And she'd even composed a dance to go with it. And then she said, my second favorite song that you do is called, Were You There When They Crucified My Lord? Have you recorded it yet? If you haven't yet, would you please do it now? So Thursday night we sang in out of Phoenix in a concert, and all of a sudden the words crushed me with what they said, because this little sixth grader got them before I did, even though I had directed it probably 100 times already. We met her Saturday morning. She's cute as a bug's ear, smart as a whip. Sixth grade, she's already in pre-algebra, already in the honors program. I'm already trying to recruit her, just so you know. Soloist is this beautiful blonde somewhere around. Her name is Laura Worthington from Issaquah. No, Laura Peak, you got married. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Riding along in the car, some of the kids said, when you choose a song, first of all, how do you choose a song? And then they said, do you like it when you first choose it? And I said, well, I always like something about it. But quite often, I have no idea, really, the depth of the song. The next song we're going to do is that one of those songs. It's called At Your Mercy Seat, a very powerful song now after performing it all these weeks. These are great kids that I get to work with, phenomenal kids, but every once in a while they say, you know, Doc, you're getting older, could we do a little faster, peppier stuff? So once in a while you throw them a carrot and hope they'll stay with you a while longer. Prepare ye the way!
The voice of a crying in the wilderness.
For those of you who thought it was too fast, I understand totally, but it's all right. You know, we started something on Sunday morning Saturday morning at the Sabbath service for the Seventh-day Adventist people. They wanted, we were in the second hour of the concert. I mean, 2 hours. And I'm thinking, man alive, it's 12:25. These people got to be tired. So we just voted on it. So, you know, if you want us to go some more, say yay. And if you want us to stop, nay. And we'll just vote tonight. So keep going. All the yays?
Yay!
Nays? Well, that's kind of what they did. So we'll do that again in a few minutes, if that's all right with everybody. So I get my pad out here. We believe.
Thank you.
Well, we ran out of regular material, and so we'd like to do two Christmas songs for you. Actually, we didn't run out of material, but I would like to do two Christmas songs for you. All those in favor say yay.
Yay.
Nays? You don't have to buy any gifts for a while, but at least enjoy Christmas. You know, I think that's a mistake we make. I was thinking about driving here today. We only have turkey at a certain time of the year. We only have ham at a certain time of year. We only have Silent Night, Holy Night, only at a certain time of year. Those are mistakes, probably. Because David over there, he has tacos every time he gets a chance. David, how are you?
I'm great, sir.
That's good. Great. Wow. That's great. Mm. Are you an English major?
Yes, sir.
Would you like to sing for these folks tonight? They don't even know how you sing. I have no idea why they voted yay. Surely I can get a nay on that one. Yeah, we got a nay over here. It's called God Has Come.
Yeah.
Can you handle one more Christmas? All right. I heard the bells on Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play, and loud and sweet the words repeat, peace on earth. He wrote it in 1865. He lost his wife 2 years before in a fire. His son was mortally wounded in the war. And as he wrote the song and the bells were pealing, he got very discouraged and depressed. Not like you Christians or these Christians, we never get depressed. But somehow in the midst of it all, he found hope when the bells rang again and rang again. And that third verse is the one that you want to hear. Because you'll hear it coming right now. Ready? Well, Merry Christmas. A wonderful piece of music, and thank you, young people, urchins, for doing so well. I suppose the fact you're down here means you want to sing.
Sure.
Is this your first year with me?
This is.
My name's Gary Bonner.
Nice to meet you. Jaron Haynes.
Jaron Haynes.
Yes, sir.
Have you been with us long?
Not that long. 6 months.
I kind of like the kid. He's good looking. By the way, somebody's going to ask me tonight about auditions. Here's the audition, just so you know. You look, that's all. We don't listen. We just look. We look. Once in a while, we ask a violin to play. You know what? Before he sings, stand up and play. Your father's here. I want to know if you're any good. Jaron, you sit. Now, is it true that your father wrote this piece of music? Just the introduction. When will we hear the whole thing? Well, we'll have to have more time than we have tonight. So, one more time, let's just tell you the story. Again, is there anybody that's never seen us before right now? Okay, it's worth doing. I was in Spain a number of years ago making a recording. I sent the money across the water. I thought I'd have an orchestra like out of Hollywood. I got there. It was really discouraging. I looked down, and the playing concert mistress, or concert master, what do you call, was this lady, this girl. That was at least 12 years ago, is that right? 6 years ago, maybe? And I was so angry. Not a Christian thing, I was just angry. Until she looked up at me and grinned. How do you grin? She cocks that head, and wow. And the Holy Spirit kind of melted everything. And so, and now Mom and Dad are here. They just came in, huh?
Yeah, I'm nervous now.
You know, I'm nervous too. Because, you know, if he's a conductor and, oh, man.
He plays the violin.
Oh, he plays the violin too? Well, we'll move him in here by the rest of these urchins. And here we go. Okay, this is Noemi. Well, I didn't mean to step on your parade. So this is Jaron, and he's going to lead you through that song we've done for a number of years called Hallelujah.
Thank you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
He's a pretty good singer, isn't he? Yeah. If we could just get him to smile a little bit, it would be good. I guess because the clock is running, I got to move. How about sooner we'll be done with the troubles of the world?
I want.
after that extra applause, I'm not going to let you sing at all. You're liable to get arrogant and be hard to handle. Harder to handle. Okay, now, young people, the clock is running and there's a limit. And I have to, after this song, you're going to roar up on that platform. We're going to go to the power of the cross. Okay? And then we're going to vote. 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 Are you okay?
Yes, sir.
David Newman, from what town?
Compton, California.
How many brothers?
Six.
Six. How many kids in college?
Six.
Lord, I keep so busy praising my Jesus. Praising my Jesus. Keep so busy praising my Jesus. Ain't got time. 'Cause when I'm a healing this sin, when I'm a healing this sin, when I'm a healing this sin, ain't got time, 'cause when I'm a feeling impulse,